There's a lot of talks about the durability of the stones, and some people saying that it's not possible to scratch the gemstone, and some people say that it is possible and actually then bring them back to their jewelers to polish. So if you can scratch them, where is the scratches coming from? Let's go through this question in details. My name is Serge, and I'm the owner of Nina Vova Custom Jewelry. I think you will all agree that in order to scratch one object, you need another one that's harder than the first one. And in jewelry, we have this beautiful scale called Mach scale that grades all the stones by hardness from 1 to 10. And the important thing to keep in mind that the gap between 9 and 10 is actually much bigger than between 1 and 9. We'll come back to it closer to the end of the video and I'll explain you why it is important. So what is that we use on a daily basis that can scratch our gemstones? Not much really. Let's say your fingernails. It's only 2.5 on Mach scale and it's not hard enough to scratch anything really. Or you carrying pockets full of coins and coins made out of copper, and it's only 3.5 on Mach scale. In comparison, the opal, one of the softest gemstones out there that used for engagement ring, 5.5. Close to that is actually nails and the knife blade. I don't think you care the knife blade or nails in your pockets unless you are Dexter and about to propose to someone. But what about the other metal objects like your door handle or your metal rails or something like that? Yes, you can scratch your gemstones because of them, but then you'll have to hit the ring with the outside part of your hand, and it's very unlikely, and usually you will feel it, so you immediately would look back if you did not hurt yourself, really. What I'm trying to say is that on a daily basis in the modern world, it's pretty hard for us to damage our jewelry or the gemstones unless we're working with metal objects or with titanium tools, for example. But most of the times we're dealing with plastic door handles, with plastic credit cards. Again, we're not really using coins anymore that much. But we still tend to think that we're damaging our rings with other objects. And it's happening because we're seeing all the scratches on our settings. But in reality, in most of the case, the way we damage our gemstones is completely different. Let's say you travel in somewhere and you put all of your jewelry together in one box. And in this box, you happen to have the diamond ring. And especially the diamond ring with a hollow setting, or it's a marquise stone without tips covering by the prongs. That's it. That's the time when you're gonna damage everything that in the box if this piece is not separated one from another. It's a very common thing to see that when you're looking through the jewelry collections, even the small one, where you have like rubies, sapphires, opals, and they were kept next to the diamond. And let's say you're going somewhere into the trip, so you put everything together in one little box or the back, which is very common. So you flew there, that's really it. It's not gonna take much for the diamond to scratch everything that's around. And as you can see from the Mach scale, even if you have the sapphire, which is grade 9 on the Mach scale, and you have the diamond, the difference between the hardness of both of them is huge, really. The difference between Mach scale 1 and Mach scale 9 is way less than between 9 and 10. That's why I said at the beginning of the video that it's a very important thing to keep in mind. But let's say you already damaged your stone or scratch it. So what to do in this case? Well, in this case, you need to bring your ring to the jeweler. And I'm saying the ring because it's really a most common thing to damage. It's really hard to damage the necklace or the bracelet. It's much easier to damage the ring. So you need to bring this ring to the jeweler, better the one who actually made this piece. and he will figure out what can be done with it. With opals, it's pretty easy. For example, that's the most common stone that people are afraid to scratch or damage, and it's actually very easy to work on it. You can always polish it, unless it's broken or something like that, which is very rare. So you can always polish it, and again, if it's broken, it's easy to replace. They're pretty inexpensive. So it's really nothing to be afraid of. You just insuring your ring at the very beginning. If something happened, the insurance would cover the repair or replacement. With sapphires and rubies, it's a little bit more complicated. If it's a very little scratch, you can always polish it. If it's a deep scratch, then it means you'll have to cut the stone again. And in this case, you need to get probably a couple of opinions what to do in this case. Because if you cutting the stone, you're naturally losing the carat weight, and you don't want to do that. So you basically losing the value of the stone. So it's maybe worth to just keep it the way it is. The value is not going to go down. I mean, it's your piece. You're going to wear it. If you're not planning on selling it, or it's not an investment piece, you should be okay with this scratch. Also, when you do repair your gemstone, make sure that your setting got repair as well. I've personally never seen the gemstones scratch or damage and the setting itself stayed the way it is, like a brand new. Usually the whole piece got damaged altogether. So most of the times what we do, we just, I would say, restoring the piece. We just taking out the stone, we just polish it all together, we straighten up the ring. It's very common actually to have this ring like damaged and bent. So we're doing all this repair as well and giving it back to the client. And also when we're making our pieces, I'm asking my clients like who they are on daily basis, how they wear things, how they taking care of them. And for me personally, a very good indication is our cell phones, our smartphones. It is usually enough to just take a look at it, and I'm asking it very gently just not to hurt anyone's feelings. I'm asking, just show me your phone, really, how old is it? And sometimes you're looking at the phones and they all cracked, even if they are in the cases. And I'm asking like, how old is it? And people are saying like, oh, it's 3 months, I just bought it. Well, in this case, let's reconsider the decision about the three prongs on the 2-carat stones. Let's maybe look at the basal setting. And you probably don't want to go with such a thin band. You probably better go with a much wider one and try to reconsider your decision about the 18-carat gold. Look towards the platinum, for example. Because I mean, we cannot change ourselves. We just need to accept it and act accordingly. So in this case, I'm just recommending to get the piece that would live happily ever after with the person who's gonna wear it. And at the opposite side, there are some people who's very, very careful about the things. And again, you can look at their phones, which are like 5 years old and perfect without any scratches or something like that. And in this case, sure, you can do opal ring, you can do very thin rose gold band, you can do that. But if you feel like this piece of jewelry, the one you want, not durable for you, ask your jeweler, he will probably find a solution. And we're all different. Some of us would go on a Sunday morning to the farmer markets, and some of us would go skydiving. That's why I'm usually asking about the lifestyle of my clients, in how I can help to do the best job possible for them so they can enjoy their pieces and not worry about breaking them. I think that's it, what I wanted to say about the durability of the gemstones and the settings in general. Of course, there is much more to say. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments. I'll be happy to answer. And I'll see you in the next video. Thank you so much for watching.